So I'm going to talk to you about CBD. What in the world is CBD? Why do we use it? What are some of the myths? What's some of the history? And how can we use it to see some health benefits in our lives? Our family has been using CBD products. These three are the CBD products from Young Living for probably about 2 years. And most every day we're using at least one of these products. And they've really been a blessing for us in multiple ways. And I'll share more of those stories as we go. I do have some notes because there is a lot of info and I want to get it all right. So also keep in mind, I'm not a doctor, I'm not a scientist, just sharing some knowledge as I'm learning, and don't ever want to diagnose, cure, or treat anything. We're just sharing knowledge, right? You do your own research. So the first thing is, what in the world is CBD? Well, first and foremost, CBD is not marijuana. You can breathe easy. Now, CBD and marijuana come from the same plant, and that's where a lot of the confusion comes from. They're like cousins to each other. They come from the same plant called the cannabis or hemp plant, but they're different varieties of the plant. Marijuana is the one that has what's called THC in it, and that is the psychoactive effects, the hallucinations and the addictive nature of it. That is THC. It comes from THC, and that's in the marijuana section of the plant. CBD comes from a different section of this same plant species, and it has very, very small amounts of THC in it. And then there are ways to extract all of that THC from the plant itself so that you're not getting any of the psychoactive effects of it. So marijuana and CBD, they might be cousins, but they are totally separate chemical compounds that don't necessarily have anything to do with each other. There's actually quite a bit of history as it relates to CBD. It originated in Asia thousands of years ago. It actually came to the United States in the 16th century. And get this, farmers in the early phases of the United States being a nation were actually penalized if they did not devote a section of their crop to hemp production. So there was an incentive for every farmer in the United States to actually grow hemp. Isn't that wild? Because hemp is so incredibly useful. I'm sure you've seen hemp ropes. Did you know the first Levi jeans were made from hemp material? Hemp can be used for paper, food, fiber, construction material, clothes, and so many other products. Now in the 19th, so hemp was a regular part of our culture. People were using it regularly. In the 1920s, there was some corruption and a big deal about the financial world, in the financial world as it related to CBD. So they made hemp a Schedule I substance, which meant it was gonna hereby be banned, basically. So from 1920 on, hemp was not widely used. In fact, it was considered a dangerous drug after 1920 because of the laws that had changed. Now, in December of 2018, just a short while ago, it was moved out of a controlled substance to becoming an unscheduled substance due to the Hemp Farming Act of 2018. It removed hemp as a controlled substance, as long as the THC value of the plant is less than 0.3%. So basically, CBD became legal again in the United States in December of 2018. It is now currently legal in all 50 states, and that's why we're seeing this huge boom in CBD production because of the laws that changed in 2018. The industry is actually set to become $20 to $40 billion strong by 2024. So people are using CBD, they're seeing the benefits of it, and there's widespread production of it. Now we have to be careful where we get it from, because CBD at the gas station is not the same as the CBD that I'm gonna feel comfortable using for my family. So let me tell you how CBD works a little bit. I know it's a little bit sciencey, hang in with me. We have what's called the endocannabinoid system in our body, just like we have an immune system and a digestive system. We have an endocannabinoid system system where cannabinoids bind to those receptors. We have endocannabinoids, say that three times fast, receptors head to toe in our body. And the endocannabinoid system helps us maintain balance, or the word is homeostasis, in each of those areas. So I'm going to read the areas in the body that the endocannabinoid system works with to maintain balance. And I want you to think as I read these, do you ever get out of balance in any of these areas? Appetite. Hello. Digestion. Immune function, inflammation, mood, energy, sleep, reproduction and fertility, temperature regulation, memory, pain, and pleasure and reward. If you get out of balance in any of those areas, the endocannabinoid system typically tries to bump it into high gear and try to get you back in balance. For example, when you get too hot, your endocannabinoid system makes you sweat to help cool you back down. If you get too cold, that system makes you shiver to warm back up. When you get hungry, your stomach growls. When you get tired, you yawn. Those are all endocannabinoid processes that happen. Now, if your body is unable to adjust and get back in balance, you start to develop disease. Now, the body produces its own cannabinoids, but it also needs help and appreciates the help if we can supplement with CBD, which are cannabinoids, to help bring balance to our whole body. That's why you will see so many people who use CBD for so many different things, because it depends what you're wanting to target on your body, and you can basically use it for everything. It has such a wide umbrella of things that it helps support in the body because of the endocannabinoid system that it is helping to support. Okay, what product do you use? Well, the main point that I want to emphasize is that you've got to be careful. This is where you do need to do your research and figure out where you're getting your CBD from, because CBD from the gas station or from a health food store could be mixed with a bunch of other junk. One thing that sets Young Living apart is that they add essential oils to their CBD products. And the scientific term for this is the entourage effect. So when you add oils, they're called terpenes, to your CBD, it like magnifies the benefit of the CBD. The entourage effect, picture like you're trying to push a piano on your own. You might get it a few inches, but it's not going to go very far. You get a whole team of people helping you push, and you're going to magnify or multiply the effort that's there. That's what CBD is doing in your body, especially when it's paired with essential oils. So here are the reasons why we choose Young Living. They have patented what's called a smart spectrum CBD. They're the only ones to do this. And here's what sets them apart. They have zero THC, 0.00% THC. You will not get addicted to this. It is not going to cause psychoactive effects. It has none of that THC in it whatsoever. They process and farm it on a farm that is organic, and they use zero harmful pesticides or chemicals. They do rigorous testing, and their quality control is second to none. In fact, the federal government said when they reviewed Young Living's quality control plan, they had never seen one that was as extensive as the Young Living plan. And they add essential oils to it. So for all those reasons, I choose Young Living. Now let me very quickly, as we wrap this up, tell you about these three products and how we use them. So the first one is the CBD oil. And we have it in a couple different flavors. This one happens to be citrus. There's not a whole lot of variance between the flavors. It is the CBD oil combined with essential oils in a dropper form. You could use this topically on an area that you want to target. It's a little bit of a gray area about using it under the tongue, so I cannot necessarily recommend that, but I can tell you that's how my family uses this. So we drop this underneath our tongue and let it dissolve and sit there for about a minute or two, and then swallow the rest. Gets into the bloodstream pretty quickly. A couple of things about this note are you should take it at the same time every day, and start with like half a dropper, and you can work your way up to two or three droppers a day if you needed to. Some pretty wild stories of how CBD has helped a lot of people who are, the CBD oil has helped people who have chronic pain, anxiety, sleep issues. They're on the spectrum. They have autoimmune issues, skin, digestive, you name it. This has tremendously helped a lot of people. Okay, the Calm Roll-On right here is probably in my top five favorite Young Living products. It smells phenomenal, and it does what it says. I do not enjoy flying in an airplane and usually have to take a lot of oils or something to help me with my anxiety when I'm flying. Well, these days I just carry this with me and I swipe it back here, swipe it on my wrist, down here, however I want, so that I can breathe it in. The aroma is so pleasant and immediately helps me to be calm. I also use this before bed if I really want to help with a good night of sleep, or if I'm just dealing with a little bit of a stressful situation and I need to chill a little bit. It's also come in handy with my kids and my dog. So there's the Calm Roll-On. Finally is the Muscle Rub. This is a 300 milligram. It also comes in 600, and you just get a little bit of the white paste. A little bit goes a long way, and rub it on whatever muscle you're wanting to target. We use this when our head is bothering us, when we have sore muscles after working or sleeping funny, any sore joints. This Muscle Rub, we go through a lot of it. A little does go a long way. You can put it on your feet, have somebody use it in a massage. Really, really, really love the Muscle Rub. It gives you a really deep sensation of healing, really. The first time David put it on, he tried it on his neck, and after a few minutes, he said, "Whoa, I have way more range of motion in my neck than I had before." It really gets down deep into your tissues and has saved the day for us on more than one occasion, for sure. So I hope that's helpful. I hope you enjoyed learning about CBD today. Would love to hear what your thoughts are and experiences or questions. So let me know. Hope you have a blessed day. Take care.